The world has changed, and the world has changed permanently. If you are any kind of a leader, maybe you work as a VP or a CEO or a C-level executive, and you want to really amp up your authority, your influence, your confidence level, so that people can really see your personality and they can be influenced by your leadership, you must understand the 7 tips that you are about to discover on how to amp up, level up, and ramp up your online presentation. So whether you do Zoom presentations, Microsoft Teams, virtual presentations on the phone, or even in near future, face-to-face presentations in front of your clients, your decision makers, your leader, make sure that you actually apply these 7 tips. Tip number 1 is stop clearing your throat. What I mean by that, not just the physical throat I'm talking about, but I'm talking about wasting time. Now, this is a classic mistake that a lot of people do. They make a bad impression in the first 7 seconds of their presentation. They come to the stage or the video presentation and they start saying, "Good morning, everybody. Good afternoon, everybody. Today we have an update meeting. Today we have a senior leadership meeting. Blah, 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 blah." Stop clearing the throat. Get to the point. Understand that people do not have that much time, but more importantly, they are distracted all the time. So to make sure that you actually get access to their primal brain, you have to differentiate yourself in the first 7 seconds. So stop clearing the throat. Tip number 2 is make sure when you're speaking, there is no distraction in the background. Recently, I was coaching some leaders, and one of the ladies inside the program, very powerful leader, she was giving a presentation for me to give her feedback on how to really amp up her persona, her body language. And one thing I saw is that when she was speaking, there was this small little thing in the background that was actually distracting, a physical thing like a small bag. Maybe the fan in the room was on and it was swinging left and right and left and right during the video presentation. And I told her during the feedback that I give her feedback on her voice, her body language, her impromptu speaking, her confidence, her persona, her presentation structure. But I told her that that thing, that bag, is actually bagging a lot of attention. The thing is, make sure that when you're speaking to people, there is no distraction in the background. Maybe your kid playing in the background, maybe there is a dog walking by. These things will actually distract the audience members from the message. You don't want that. Tip number 3 is make sure you have some compelling slides. Not some boring slides, some compelling slides. Do not take pages and photos from Google, but make sure your slides really impact the people to think differently. For example, a couple of months back, I was coaching a very high-level CEO. If I tell you his name, you'll know, man, that guy also got trained by you. Yes, I told him that he's inspiring his team to be better leaders. And I told him, do not use boring slides. Do not, you know, use slides from stock photos. I said, put a slide where there is a photo of a tiger and a deer. And you ask the people, do you want to be the deer who gets eaten by powerful leaders, or do you want to be that tiger, that powerful leader who's actually going and attacking, right? So see, compelling slides will give you a message. Now, whether you are doing technical presentations, educational presentations, informative presentations, leadership presentations, update meetings, stakeholder meetings, client meetings, you can absolutely learn how to use compelling slides. If you don't know how to do it, make sure you reach out to us. We're going to help you. Tip number 4 is utilizing poll feature. There are different sites that can do that, but these days all the major video conferencing has a poll feature. Now, I'm not talking about the chat feature, a poll feature where you can use a live poll. And if you don't know how to do it, you know, make sure you reach out to us. Come to our next event. I can guide you, coach you, and mentor you on how to use it. Poll feature really engages people, because they understand whether it's virtual stage or real stage, if you want them to engage, you really want to make sure that it is a two-way conversation, not a one-way talk. Number 5 is use 4x6 note cards. You can take up, you know, A4 sheet and you can really cut it off to 4x6. That's fine too, but get some A4 4x6, you know, cards from a stationery shop. The reason for that is make sure when you're speaking, you have some note cards available. You should not have, you know, things written down line after line, because you'll forget. What you want is 4x6 note cards where you basically have some bullet points written down. So anytime you want to know what is the next point, you have some ideas, some prompts for you to follow. Tip number 6 is body language. Understand that body language is more powerful than spoken language, especially in digital presentations, online public speaking. You're doing virtual presentations, maybe to people from Japan, from Singapore, from US, from UK, from any part of the world, any part of the country, using body language. People don't want to just hear what you say, they want to experience your feeling, your emotions, how you say it. That's how you become not just a manager, a leader, right? So using body language, your hand gestures, your facial expressions, utilizing at the right time, not just to use it, but with a purpose, will give you an edge that most people are missing. And tip number 7 is humor. Humor is crucial. I remember recently I was coaching, you know, a leader who actually is writing a book, and he asked me, Bishal, how do I write a book? You know, do you have some tips for that? Now, I paused and I said, hey, do you have kids? He said, yes. I said, how many? He said, 2 kids. I said, okay, so you already have 2 customers. And he started laughing. Why? Because humor. Of course, I gave him the tips and all that, but the thing is humor. Understand that you don't want to be too serious. You want to be sincere, but you also want to be fun. I'm not asking you to be Kapil Sharma. I'm not asking you to be, you know, joking with people, but I'm asking you to have some light humor that can really lighten up the mood and actually give you the control as a speaker. So these are the 7 tips that if you apply, it's going to give you the edge as a speaker that you are. And look, I can't wait to help you, you know, I can't wait to help you achieve that transformation in your life, which is why I have actually recently opened a program called Rock Your Speaking Foundation, that no matter where you are, you can absolutely get my direct mentorship to help you. So you don't have to continue dealing with confidence issues or body language issues or personal issues, because you already are a great leader. Now the question is, you know, every single time you don't give your 100% best, isn't it costing you? Maybe it's not costing you money, but isn't it costing you your reputation? And if you don't care for your reputation, that's absolutely fine, but you don't have to continue dealing with reputation problem. And I want that for you. I want you to really amp up your reputation, amp up your career path, so that you go to the top level in your career. And I've seen how powerful it can be for leaders like you, because I've been mentoring a lot of the people, and I know that this can be a game changer for you. And I want to offer you the same opportunity to get this into your life. So if you want to avoid being an average speaker or even good speaker, and if you really want to, instead of that, if you really want to become a powerful speaker with high level confidence, high level influence, powerful executive presence, so that you can have flawless flow when you speak, handle question answers like a pro, make an impeccable impact with powerful voice, body language, attention, so that you hold the attention, grab the attention, and direct people's attention, then here is what you do next. There is a number there, you can call the number, talk to one of our team members and tell them that I want to be mentored by Bishal Sarkar in his program. Can Bishal give feedback to me and coaching to me? We're going to invite you to a masterclass. Come attend and we will change your life. I'll personally be there for you. Bishal Sarkar here. It's been a privilege talking to you for the last 7.5 minutes, reminding you that influential speaking is not about perfection, it's all about connection.